Hallelujah. A pleasant good morning to everyone. Are you all right? God is good, and all the time He is good. I want you to stand with me this morning. Hallelujah. As we give God collective praise and glory. I guess during the week it was all by yourself. Amen? But today we are gathered together in His name to worship Him and to give Him glory and honor. Hallelujah. Somebody just give God a clap offering this morning because of His goodness and His love and His mercies. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's just worship God this morning. Hallelujah. God, we worship You, Jesus. We worship You, we worship You. Hallelujah, God, we give You all the glory. We give You all the honor. We give You all the praise that You deserve this morning. God, there is none like You. God, You are our sustainer. God, You are our need supply. God, You are our everything this morning. And so, God, we say thank You. Thank You for sparing our lives. Thank You for providing for us this morning. Hallelujah, God, we worship You. Lord, we worship You, God. There is none like You. There is none like You, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are our refuge and our strength, our very present help in the time of trouble. God, hallelujah, You are a rock. You are a sword, You are a shield this morning. And so, God, we say thank You. We bow down and we worship You, God. Lord, we bow down and we give You the glory that You deserve, the honor that You deserve, God. Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus this morning, we ask You, oh God, to cleanse us from unrighteousness. Father, we ask You to clean us, oh God, hallelujah, so that our worship, oh God, will make sense. Our worship would not be a waste of time, but God, our worship will bring glory and honor to Your name. God, I pray that every song that we sing this morning, God, every song, every word that we speak, oh God, every breath that we take this morning, You will be honored by it. And God, in the mighty name of Jesus, I ask You to take charge and control of this morning's worship. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, touch Your people wherever, oh God, we have a need, supply it, oh God, for You said in Your word, ask and it shall be given. God, You said to seek and it shall find. You said to knock and the door shall be opened. God, in the mighty name of Jesus, I pray that we're going to cry out to You. We're going to cry out to You from the very depths of our hearts. And God, may You hear and may You answer our prayers this morning. And so, Satan, I serve Your notice. I pray that You will give Your people liberty to worship, for the garment of praise is for the spirit of heaviness. And so this morning, we lift up the entire proceedings to You. And may You have Your divine way in Jesus' name. Somebody put your hands together for Jesus Christ this morning. God, we thank You for Your goodness. We thank You for Your faithfulness. We thank You for Your friendship. God, we thank You for Your closeness. We thank You, God, for everything that You've done. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank You, Jesus. We're going to read from Psalms 61. And this psalm simply tells us that David took refuge in God. And this morning, that's where we need to find our refuge. A man, a woman, friends, they may be there, you know, but they cannot be there the way that God will be there for you. So this morning, take refuge and take heart in knowing that God is there for you. It says, hear my cry, O God. Attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto Thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For Thou hast been a shelter for me, and a strong tower from the enemy. I will abide in thy tabernacle forever. I will trust in the covert of the wings. For thou, O God, hast heard my vows. Thou hast given me the heritage of those that fear thy name. Thou wilt prolong the king's life and his years as many generations. He shall abide before God forever. O, prepare mercy and truth, which may preserve him. So will I sing unto thy name forever, that I may daily perform my vows. And may God bless you this morning as we continue to cry out to God. Whatever it is this morning that you need from God, trust him. He's able. He's able. Do you believe it? He is able. I serve an able God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, somebody, lift your voice this morning. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. Hey. My heart, my mind, my soul belongs to you. My love, my life, it all belongs to you. Give it your heart, yeah. Yes, belongs to you. Just turn it all over to Jesus. He loves you. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, keep giving God praise this morning. He's a mighty God. Hallelujah. Nobody like Jesus this morning. Hallelujah. Hey, thank you, Jesus. Hey, I climbed up to the highest mountain, looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Somebody sing with me this morning. I went down into the deepest valley, looked all around, down there, couldn't find nobody. Come on, somebody, you know what I'm talking about this morning. I went across the deep blue sea, couldn't find one to compare to your grace, your love, your mercy. Say, nobody greater, nobody greater than you. Come on, somebody, say. Oh, when I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. Hey, I looked high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody. nobody greater. Nobody greater, Lord. Nobody greater than you. Somebody, you know what I'm talking about. Say, hey, nobody, oh, greater than you. Hallelujah. Cause I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I looked high and low, I still couldn't find nobody. Cause nobody. Hallelujah. Nobody's greater than you this morning, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. This morning he's too faithful to leave you. He's too committed to leave you halfway. That's the God we serve. He would never, ever do this. It's not in his DNA this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody sing. Sing about the goodness of your God this morning. Hallelujah. Yeah. Today and forevermore, what you say is what you do. You never fail, you never change. You are faithful till the end. Faithful God, I worship you. Me. You've proven yourself in my life. Because I remember when I had to make that decision, I went on my knees and I came right here and I said, God, this is the situation and I want the answer. And God gave me the answer on my knees. And this is how I've lived my life, and I'm not lying. Every single day, every major decision that I've made in my life, I've consulted God. And so if you want God to bless you and to favor you, seek Him first. Hallelujah. God, you're faithful. Faithful is your name. Faithful, faithful, faithful God. Hallelujah. He's God all by Himself this morning. Hallelujah. I serve the best God in the world. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God, you're worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, He's not a God created by human hands this morning. Come on, sing with me this morning as though you know.
You are not a God created by human hands. You are not a God dependent on any mortal man. You are not a God in need of anything we can give by your plan. That's just the way it is. You are God alone. From before time began, God is on his throne and he doesn't need any help. He is God alone. And right now, whatever you're going through, in the good times and the bad, God is on his throne.
Help me.
You are God alone. He doesn't need me, you know. He doesn't need you. From before time began, you are on your throne. You are God alone.
And that's the choice you gotta make.
And right now, in the good times and the bad,
he loves to be by himself.
You are God alone. From before time began, you are on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, in the good times and the bad, you are on your throne.
You are God.
Lord, you're unstoppable. That's who you are.
You're unchangeable.
Lord, you're unshakable. You're unstoppable. That's who you are.
Put your hands together for Jesus this morning. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. So this morning we're going to take this morning's tithes and offering, and I'm going to ask Sister Foster to pray for us this morning. Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you, oh God. We thank you for this day which you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Heavenly Father, this morning, as we are about to bring before you our tithes and offering, Lord, we pray even as you have blessed us that we are going to bless you back, Lord, that we're going to come before you this morning in worship as we give unto you, Heavenly Father. And I pray as we give to you today that you are going to bless this offering, bless the tithes, bless the givers, oh God, for indeed you have been good to us. And I pray, God, that the return is going to come 1,000-fold, 100-fold, God, as you see fit, because you are God alone. But I pray that you would rebuke the devourer, oh God, and the destroyer, Heavenly Father, and God, that you would bless and multiply and cause us to come before you again, bringing more and more unto you, God, even as you would have blessed us. And touch those who doesn't have this morning. You are the way maker. Make a way, God, where there seems to be no way. Create jobs, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray that finances would come from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west. I call it unto them this morning in the name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you as you bless it today in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. You know what? When you live the lyrics, the song hits for real, eh? Yeah, when you've lived it, it hits different. Take it again. Let's take it again. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. For us this morning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Pleasant good morning to everyone. How many of us can attest to the goodness and the mercies of God this morning? He has been good. He has taken us from something we have thought would not have made it. We are standing here this morning. Just want to give him thanks and praise this morning.
What the mercy of God can do. If you knew me then, you'd believe me now. He turned my whole life upside down. Took the old and he made it new. That's just what the mercy of God can do. Now I'm alive to tell the story, how I've overcome. It's his goodness and mercy and the power of the blood. I'm so glad that my freedom, it wasn't based on what I've done. It's his goodness and mercy and the power of the blood. Choices made and I regret. Oh, I would still be lost. Oh, but for the mercy of God. Now I'm alive to tell the story, how I've overcome. It's his goodness and mercy. Wasn't based on what I've done, but his goodness and mercy and the power of the blood. Oh, the power of my Savior's blood, it's Jesus' blood, was the cross meant for me, that my goodness and mercy and the power of his blood. I'm so glad that my freedom, it wasn't based on what I've done. It's his goodness and mercy and the power of the blood. It's his goodness and mercy.
conclusive power. Oh, mind healing power. I know there's body healing power. Somebody say, power in the blood. Oh, power in the blood. I know there's power in the blood. There's the power in the blood. What's the cross? Meant for me that my Savior carried on, been made free by the mercy of God, and was the grave meant for me where my sin lay buried on, stand redeemed by the mercy of God. Was the cross meant for me that my Savior carried? No, I stand redeemed by the mercy of God. And was the grave meant for me where my sin lay buried? No, I stand redeemed by the mercy.
Bless you, Tyrell. What can wash away my sins? Nothing. Not bleach, not tide, not gain, but the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Put your hands together for Jesus again this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 God, we bless your name this morning. As we prepare for the word, I just want you to stand for the final time. And this morning, I want you to greet someone. We have not done that in a long, long time. If you feel to shake a hand or to just encourage someone, do that this morning. People are suffering silently. I'm telling you this because I know. And we need to look out for each other a little bit more, people. Trust me, we really do. We can't be by ourselves. We need people. So if you have not seen someone, reach out. Find out what's going on. Amen? They may just need someone to speak to. Hallelujah.
You're my brother, you're my sister. So take me by the hand. Together we will till he comes. When we walk in side by side, as long as
encourage somebody this morning, they may need a hug. Come on, sing.
You're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by.
Together we will work
till he comes. There's no one that can defeat us when we walk in side by side. As long as there is love. till he comes. There's no one that can defeat us when we walk in side by side. As long as there is love,
sorry,
we will stand. You're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by the hand. Together, oh, we will work till he comes. The same road, yet we build divided walls. And I say,
you're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by the hand. Together we will work till we come.
There's no one that can defeat us when we walk in side by side. As long as there is love,
we will stand.
You're my sister, so take me by the hand.
Together we will work
till he comes. There's no one that can defeat us when we walk in side by side.
Somebody say,
as long as
there is love,
hey, so take me by my hand. Together we can work till he comes. There's no one that can defeat us when we walk in side by side.
As long as there is love, we will stand.
As long there is love, we will stand.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. Hamoshikor Mahando Mo Sabao. Hallelujah. I worship you, Jesus. I bow down before you, Jesus. Because you are Lord, you are God. Hamoshotoraboyon. There is none like you. Hallelujah. Woohoo! I believe the story. I believe the story that God became a man for me and died on the cross of Calvary. I believe the story. Woo, and that's what keeps me going. There is something supernatural. This story is not an ordinary story. Have you ever heard a story like that? None. Hallelujah. You may have a seat. God, in his infinite goodness, condescended, assumed the human body, and gave it to die on a cross that I could be forgiven. Woo, hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why I'm here this morning. That's why I'm here this morning. When I left home this morning, I purposed in my heart, because you know sometimes we could just go to church. I don't want to just go to church. I want to go to church with purpose. I made up in my heart that I'm coming here to worship God, to acknowledge God, you know, to let him know that I know that he's a good God, and to give him thanks and to honor him and, you know, and just to praise him for his goodness. Yeah, that's why I'm here this morning. I made up my mind. That's why I came here. This day is exclusively given to worshiping God. Amen. This place was made to worship God. Amen. And that's why I'm here. And I just want to thank God this morning. Hallelujah. Let me greet you all and to welcome you in the house of God. Particularly those of you that are our guests today. It's so nice to have you. I hope you feel comfortable and that you're getting an opportunity to worship God. I want to say a very special welcome to Sister Rosalyn and Sister Donna, as the sisters of Sister O'Neill. They have been foundation members of this church, and we do honor you and appreciate your contribution. You have contributed to the growth of this church, and I just want to thank you. Is there anybody this morning that I've missed? Is it okay? Well, just wave a hand because I can't recognize you from here. I don't know. Nobody told me. I hope you're okay then. All right. Because some people don't want to be noticed and called upon. I want to thank Nicole and the worshipers this morning, and Jason and Nixon. Amen. And I want to thank all of you faithful people, people that have been with this ministry thick and thin, through good times and bad, that you've remained faithful. This is your church, this is your place of worship, and you're not ashamed of it. Hallelujah. I just want to thank you, and I just want to pour my blessings on you this morning. I want God to bless you for your sacrifice. I want God to bless you for your contribution. All those of you, there are people who have worked hard. There are people who are working hard, and there are some people who will continue to work hard, working hard for this church and for God. Amen. But you know, God is not going to work for himself, right? God's going to always call people to do stuff. Somebody. You ever see God come and do stuff? No, you never saw him. He's going to do it through somebody. And you are that somebody. So don't think that you're just so ordinary for all of that. Hallelujah. So again, may God bless you real good. I want to encourage you. And I want to impress upon you to continue to serve God. Continue to serve God. As I was saying this morning, I'm here. You know, when I think about the goodness of God, when I think about it, it must be the grace of God in my life. It must be the grace of God. I didn't go through this. Listen, I've been in church for 48 years. 48 years. And I'm not boasting that. I'm talking about, how you want to call me? Livingston, Judge, whoever, whatever I want to say. How did you get here? How did you make it? I don't know. Could I be really, really honest with you this morning? Out of the 48 years, as a child of God, as a Christian, and don't let that scare you, I've only been happy for 3 years. The first three baby years of my life. And you're awfully quiet. And so if for 3 from 48 is how much, you could come better than me. 45 years I've been a warrior. I've been a warrior. I faced every battle. I feel the pain of war. Hallelujah. And there are those of you who are here this morning. 3 years you've felt my pain. You've seen all side of me. See me when I'm emotional, happy. See me when I'm vexed. See me when I'm anointed. See me when I don't feel I could take no more. But this is a strange thing. God is a strange God. That God will call you and put you in a situation where your life is not even yours. Amen. I never had a life. I never had a life. Listen to me. I, George Livingston Fletcher, never had a life. Never. Never been relaxed, nothing. I've always been a warrior. And I don't know how I got here. And this morning I was saying, you see, I just put pen to paper, pen to hand. 48 years of warfare. But God, I could only give that to God. Only to God. In myself, I couldn't make it. And there are those of you who believe that when you give your heart to God, that your troubles are over. That's not true. That's the furthest thing away from the truth. When I came to God, I was so happy that I'd buried the hatchet. All my enemies, I'd forgiven them. And I asked them for forgiveness. All those people that I hated, I started loving them. And I made an oath to God. I'll never be a bad man again. I'm going to be a nice guy. And I told God, I said, God, I don't want to be nothing in church. Because I couldn't be anything. I couldn't read. I could hardly read the Bible at that time. And that's the truth. I remember the first night I came to FTH. They asked me to read from the, because they see this tall, handsome, looking, intelligent man. They asked me to read
from the 17th chapter of Revelation. I couldn't read it. So I told God, I said, God, I'm going to sit in the back of the church, and that's good enough for me. And I thought that I was the happiest man sitting in the back of the church. But I didn't know God had plans for me. God had plans for me. I didn't even know it. I just decided to walk with God, and this is where he took me. And I'm not saying this boastfully this morning. I'm saying this with utter humility. I don't know how I got here. I don't know. So that's why I want to thank God. Hallelujah. Bahura manyo. I want to thank God. I shouldn't have made it. I couldn't have made it. I couldn't. You don't know. You don't know. None of you know. None of you know. And I can't tell you. I've been a fighter. God in me. God preserved me. You don't know. And I can't tell you. But I could only look back to God and say, God, did I get here? Well, I did. I don't know how long again. I don't know. I have no idea. He said three score and ten. And some people can't even wait. He said 70, right? But wait a little while now. So let me expire. Some people can't wait for me to expire. Oh, God. Woo. But I don't know, because you really don't know. I don't know when I'm going to die. I don't know when this is going to over. I have no idea. He didn't tell me. Probably tell some people, but he didn't tell me. So I just have to keep doing what I have to do until he tell me, right? Or until he bury me someplace. Moses died, and God didn't tell nobody. It's after his death, God told Joshua, he said, listen, Moses is dead. And just as I've been with you, I've been with him, I'm going to be with you. And he took care of his body. Paul said, he said, I fought a good fight. And I finished my course. I finished. It's done. So there comes a time when it's done. Yeah? And I have no problem with that. Absolutely. But it's all in the hand of God. All I'm saying is, I am here now. And I don't know how I got here. I couldn't have made it on my own. Never. I didn't have what it takes. I didn't have a noble family. I didn't have money. I didn't have education. I came only from Butch Grove. I shouldn't have. I couldn't have. But God is a miracle working God. And that's what excites me. Because he takes some nothing and made something. He takes some nobody and makes some. He takes some nowhere and make somewhere. I mean, God. God is amazing. He promised us. He said, I'm going to take the weak things of the world to confound the mighty things. That's his word. So when he takes a nobody, don't fuss about it. And he takes a nowhere. They say, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Nazareth became a place. Don't you hear when we say Jesus of Nazareth? Hallelujah. Jerusalem, a nowhere, a little dot on the face of the earth. Barren land, nothing. And nobody. When they looked at Jesus, he was not comely. Nothing about him that they should look at. Woo! He came from nowhere. He was a nobody. Everybody aspiring to be somebody. And everybody, you know, they want this big resume. Well, strange enough, God does it the other way. He looks for the weak. He says, let the weak see. I'm strong. Ooh, glory to God. And so this morning you might be wondering, why is this guy behaving like this? Listen, I am here full of gratitude. I don't know how it happened. 48 years. Gone on the 12th of February. 9 o'clock p.m. that night. I turned my life to God. And it's still his. Woo! Because I know he promised he's never going to leave me. He never left. I mean, through all my troubles, I wonder if he was there. But sometimes when I look back, I said, oh, it had to be him. He must have, yeah. How did I get through this? You don't know how I got through this. You don't know how I got through this. You don't know how I got through this. You don't know. God alone. And I want to worship him this morning. Hallelujah. Katora ba santos na vida la mañana. Aba ha santos na vida. If you have your Bible, and whereas you should, I would like for you to turn with me, please, to the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. And just before we read from verse 1 to 5, let us pray. God Almighty, I come here this morning to worship you. I sensed and I knew that I was going to be the preacher this morning. And so, Lord God, as you gave me the thoughts, I put them together. And Lord, I have physically prepared myself to preach, but it's not by might, nor by power, but it's by my spirit, said God. And so, Lord, I don't deserve your help. I need your help. So help me this morning in a humble way to dissect your word and to proclaim your word to your people. In Jesus' name, amen. He says, but of the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I write unto you. For yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. For when they shall say peace and safety, then shall sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. But ye, brethren, are not of darkness, that day should overtake you as a thief. Ye are all the children of light, and the children of the day. We are not of the night, nor of darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. A Ahuraman Shantana. Let us not sleep as do others, but watch and be sober. This morning, this is my message to you. Do not sleep. Do not sleep, church. But watch and be sober. We cannot sleep at this time. No. Because Jesus said that he will come as a thief in the night. Usta mañana, Jesus said, he will come when you don't expect him. Jesus said, he will come when you don't expect him. And so that was the message of the Apostle Paul to the Thessalonican people. Don't sleep. Jesus is going to come. He said, and it's going to be at a time when they shall say, peace, it's okay. Then he shall break through like birth pain on the earth. Well, we've tried to interpret, but we don't know. However, to sleep makes you inactive. You're almost dead. You're just breathing, but you're not doing nothing. So what is he saying? Don't just lie there not doing nothing and be inactive. Are you active? Are you active? And I mean active, spiritually active for God. Are you occupying the precious time that God has given you? Are you wasting your time? Do you have regrets that you've wasted time? Do you have to redeem the times because the days are evil? Do you have to make up because of what you did not do? How many of us are sorry this morning that you didn't do as much as you could? There are a lot of people that are without a certificate today, not that they don't have the brain, but they didn't do, and they regret. There are a lot of people who have missed a good life. They could have put more into it, but now they look back with regret. Well, I'm here to tell you, if we miss Jesus, it's going to be the greatest regret ever. Amen. Ever! Don't be inactive. It means to be dormant. Dead. I'm doing nothing. Oh my God. How many of us are dormant? You're just there. Oh my God, you're just there. Oh my God, you're just there. What are you doing? Are you a child of God? What spirit is inside of you that have you so dead? That you're dormant? Woo! I'm trying to figure it out here now. What spirit could be in somebody that, Lord have mercy. To be slothful. You are not alert. You're careless. To be slothful. Take things for granted. Say, be not slothful in business, but in fervent in spirit. Fervent, fiery, hot. Full of motion and energy. Not slothful. or many of us, we just did. No. Remember, he said, do not sleep as others, but watch and be sober. But watch and be sober. Do not neglect and just rest. You neglect all everything else. You're resting. To remiss. But he said, watch. Be attentive. Be alert. Watch what's taking place. Because the thief is going to come in the night. And above all, he says, be sober. Be sober. Well, if you understand what it is to be sober, you will also have to understand what it is to be drunk. To be drunk is when you've been brought under the influence of a drug or something. An addiction. Something. But he said, watch and be sober. Don't be drunk. So he's likening drunkenness to a type of sleep. When your faculties do not function effectively. Drunk people hear good things bad. Soft things loud. They hear what was not said. They swagger. You're not walking straight. They feel strong when they're weak. Oh my God, isn't that awful? I remember hearing a drunk man say, he said, I feel I could raise the pool. You know what's the pool? The nutmeg pool. For those of you that are looking at me online, you don't know the nutmeg pool. One of the biggest concrete structure in Butch Grove is a nutmeg pool. And this drunk, whatever, said, I feel like I could raise the pool. And listen, that's what Paul is saying. Be sober. Don't get out of your mind and feel things and say things. No. No, don't go there. Don't allow that to happen to you. I remember this man under the influence of marijuana. And he was telling me. He said, Fletcher, I just call people when they're 30 feet away. They pass me. He said, they gone 30 feet and then I said, hey, hello, hello. He think they're just there. No, but they're 30 feet away, but he seen them just by. Yeah. This guy was going home one night. The same little drain, what we call a schism, that you have to cross to go. He doing that effortless every day. But that night he was under the influence of marijuana. So he was seeing the drain. He wondered why this drain so big. But he taking a speed on it. Sizing up. Like he's some long jumper. To jump across the drain. And he jumped so hard, he fell down and bruised up himself. The same little drain. Drunkenness. Watch, there are some people who call themselves Christian. They're drunk as a bat. Amen. They're hearing things and seeing things and feeling things that is not real. Musandoro Satanda, he said, and do not sleep as others. Don't get drunk. Be alert. And be sober. Oh my God, what a warning. Because we have work to do. The night is fast spent. The day is coming on. He says, you're not children of the night. You're children of the day. You got to walk while it is day, for the night cometh when no man can walk. Jesus said. And furthermore, as Jesus always gave parables, he gave the parable of a farmer who planted a field of wheat. But Jesus said, while the farmer slept, the enemy came and planted wheat. When did he do it? While he was sleeping. So you see, when the enemy gets the time to plant those stuff in our lives, when we sleep. And we know this morning that we're not talking about when your eyes close and your faculties is going to rest. No. The spiritual sleep. When you remiss. When you're dormant. When you're unoccupied. He says that good for nothing came while the guy was asleep. Oh, while the farmer was asleep. Listen to me. The only time he's going to get time to do that to you. And if it has done, if it happened, you see all those things that are in your heart and bad stuff. You're unlike what you used to be. You're not half the man you used to be. Your shadow hanging over you. Something just gone wrong. You were sleeping. You were sleeping when you listened to that trash. You were sleeping when you believed that trash. You were sleeping, believe me. When you said those things that you shouldn't say, you were sleeping. You were sleeping. See, and watch. Keep your head on. You have an enemy. So while he slept, the enemy came. So while he slept, the enemy will always take advantage of our slumber. You see, when they put you under the anesthesia, yeah, they could do anything with you. There are some thieves these days. They have the thing and they just blow it in your face or in the kerchief and they. I remember one time I went to extract a nail. And all the doctor said to me was, George, take a deep breath. And that was it. Honestly. They cut your leg off that time. And you don't feel nothing. Because you're sleeping. You're dead. Paul says, do not sleep as others. There are others who slept and got themselves in eternal trouble. Not just trouble, but eternal trouble. There are some people who had gone to sleep and they wish they had never slept because of the rottenness that came out of it. They wish they had their life to live all over again because of one moment of slumber. One moment of slumber. One moment of indiscretion. One moment of stupidness. They paid for it forever. I remember one night I was traveling tired from St. George's. I just got myself a Pathfinder, the nicest vehicle that I'd owned at the time. And I'm coming over the hills. I don't know when it happened. I only heard bang. And I was off the road, smashed on a tree. What? I fell asleep in a split second. And there are those who have fell asleep on the wheel, and they're nowhere today. One moment of slumber. You're not sleeping your spiritual life. You're looking for trouble. Baby, wake up. Come on. Come on. There are sometimes you have to do stuff not to sleep. Wash your face now. Get up and walk now. Get up and do something now. Stop being in this position because you're going to sleep. You see where you are there? You see where some of us are? And we could tell when he's coming on, eh? Yeah. Your body starts feeling heavy. And then you start yawning. Something happening. There's some people yawning and they want to go and wash your face now. Look at your spiritual condition. Go and wash your face now. Walk and take a little exercise now. Eat something. Do something now. Oh, God. He said, do not sleep. As others. Because what happened to them? Paul said, he said, be sober. Be vigilant. Why? For your adversary, the devil, is like a roaring lion seeking whom he might love. What? No, that's not what there. So we're not scared about that? Seeking whom he may destroy. This is no joke, buddy. This is serious business. Sober, be vigilant for your adversary. The devil is like a roaring lion. Just looking for the prey. Just want to, you and me. That's why I tell you, after 48 years, I don't know how I escaped the lion's jaw. I don't know. I was supposed to be dead spiritually. I was supposed to be dead physically. I was supposed to be dead financially. Listen, every trick in the book was against me. Take my money. To take my health. To take the anointing. And that's what he's after most of all. The presence of God in one's life. That's his prize. Pray. You know what he wants you to do? He wants us to start functioning mechanically. No, you don't want your hand or spirit. No anointing, no nothing. Just do stuff. Just do stuff. Like an engine, just turn you on, crank you on. And so when we come, we say hallelujah, hallelujah. Say praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let's go to church today. We'll go to church. Lord have mercy. Hug people, tell them you love them. Whew. That's what he wants. And if he could get us there, he don't want no more. And that's why sometimes we just wonder, well, how these bad people and them surviving? He wants them there. But a woman wicked. And a woman in church and she wicked. She ain't getting sick. She ain't getting persecution. She ain't getting nothing. She going like Old Man River. But she dead. And that's what he wants. He already have her soul. I tell you, I see some people. I don't know if you've ever seen somebody who is soulless. Well, I've been around long enough to see soulless people. No conviction, no sorrow, no remorse, no nothing. Don't watch me, so I'm telling you, I know that what I'm telling you there. No repentance. Just there. And when they get crank and they're cranking on, just like if it's a real engine, like if they're fire. Soulless, they dead. So, shall I show you one or two that had some devastating sleep? Well, let's take Jonah for example. Listen, and that's a sign, eh? The Bible says that God called Jonah to go to Nineveh. He decided he's not going. So, he paid his fare for another destination, totally opposite to where God sent him. And there are a lot of us like that. We want to do something for God, but not what God tells us to do. We see other people doing that and we like it. We hear other people this and we like that. That is what we want God. So Jonah, making a long story short, decided he ain't going. So because of him, or he became the culprit on board, there was a mighty tempest, a storm that was raging, and you know, the ship was in danger of sinking, of being broken. So by that time, the captain of the ship realized, no, something's wrong here. And you know God dealing with his captain, you know, he tell himself. He had a word from God, a wisdom word. That's not a word of wisdom. It may be a sentence, but it's a word. He said, there is a culprit on board, and that is why this thing going so. So, they went down under the deck, and they searched through the luggage, the cargo, and they find a man sleeping. They say, who you for? Where you come out? What you doing here? This commotion taking place and you're sleeping? Lord, they said, no, boy, something really wrong with you. Come on, tell us who you are. Something wrong with you. Yeah. Listen, when you see people going through that kind of stillness, yeah, with all the commotion and confusion, yeah. 99.9, that's the culprit. Yes, sir. Jonah was sleeping, but everybody was in trouble. You're going to tell me you're sleeping when the world is in this trouble, when your country is in this trouble, when your church is in this trouble, when all the commotion is taking among young people? Oh, God! Commotion everywhere, but you don't care. Something, you can't fool me. Because you see, I understand the story of Jonah. When you see people so quiet in a turbulent place, a screw slack. Oh, what's going on? Look here, that's going. Don't let that be you. I'm not talking about you this morning. I mean, you're going. Besides the noise and haste, you just, okay. Church could dead. Nothing. Family going astray. Nothing. No extra prayer, no praying, no nothing. Just there. Let me tell you something. Something wrong when you see people sleeping in those conditions. Trust me. Yeah, trust me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some people sleeping in odd places. In the physical realm. You ever see some people sleeping in church, how awful they look? As soon as they put on their bottom, they're sleeping. It doesn't look right. Don't you know it's a sickness? What do you call that? Most of our doctors, somebody I understand something. What do you call this thing when people just, anything they do, they're sleeping? Once you sit down. Oh, Lord. Was something wrong? Something is definitely wrong. If you could sleep under those circumstances and you could sleep anyway, your body wrong. And if it's happening in your spirit wrong. Amen. The ship was in trouble, but Jonah was sleeping. So let's just talk about a sleeping church. Ever had a sleeping church? Ever experienced a sleeping church? Okay. You probably experienced sleeping people, but you didn't experience a sleeping church. Okay. If you have your Bible, you'll read with me. Turn with me to the book of Revelation. Not Hebrew, Revelation. Right. So listen the contents of a sleeping church. Unto the angel of the church of Ephesus write, these things saith he that holdeth the seven stars in his right hand and walked in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks. Yeah, that's Revelation 2, right? Revelation, yeah, chapter 2, beginning from verse 1. He said, I know thy works. Listen to that carefully. I know thy works and thy labor and thy patience and how thou canst not bear them which say which are evil. I carry this prince are too small for me. Can somebody help me? You'll do a better work. Help me please, sister. Yeah. I know thy works and thy labor and your patience. I know that. Mm-hmm. And how you really do not function well among evil people. Mm-hmm. And you put them to test and found them liars that say they are apostles and sometimes pastors and sometimes Christian too. But apostles. Well, we're not elaborating on that this morning. Come on. Mm-hmm. Hold on there. He said, you see all those wonderful things? I have something against you. Come on. Because you have divorced your first love. Simply, you do not love me. Some people say that you do not love me as before. No. He was saying, you do not love me. You are functioning out of emotion. You are mechanical. You're just doing that for people to see. You just play in church. You don't have nothing in you. You're dead, you're sleeping. He said, listen, I tell you, God does watch things and see things. You remember I was telling you a story a couple of weeks ago? Then I put my hand under a woman's clothes where I wasn't supposed to be, and I feel a tattoo. God, with all the nice things they're doing there, God say, I feel your tattoo. And I could read it with my hands. Oh my God. And scary. He said, look at how you're showing off. But you know good. You don't love me. Some people say you don't love me before. You just don't love me. And you're moving mechanically. How many of us in this place just in church because people know we used to go to church? People know we baptize. People know that we used to preach. That's the only reason. But God knows the truth. He said, you do not love me. You do not love me. Listen, the worst thing to do is to endure a relationship. That is the worst thing. A bad marriage is the closest thing to the devil's hell. The closest thing to a relationship, watch me. If you don't love the man, leave him. If you don't love the woman, leave her. Is that a say so? Or whatever you do. But that ain't making sense. I remember telling you when I was speaking in prayer meeting a couple of nights and I was reminded of a story that I told you one time. I was in a party dancing with one of my girlfriends. And in the midst of the dance, the woman stopped and she said, wait. Something wrong here. Because I dance in here, but my mind in miles. So she pick up on me that this boy ain't here. So I dancing, you know. But she feeling me, she tells herself, that's not the dance I used to know. If a woman can know that this is not the dance she used to know, what about God? So you think that God doesn't know when we become mechanical? Amen. Or you think he's stupid? Yeah. Woo good! May God have mercy on church hypocrisy. Yeah. And we just vex when people say we hypocrite, you know. Well, that's one set of people I doesn't vex with. And then they tell me, are you hypocrite? I say, yes. Because it is the real truth. When those sinners want to do what they want to do, they're doing it in big. It's only church people that has hide. Those hypocrites. So when they tell us, I know what's going on. You think I should be at 48? I tell you, are they 48 years? You tell me. You think I would know a thing or two? Come on, man. Come on. 48 years, you think I would know a thing or two? I learned some things. And so when they say, are you a hypocrite? I say, yeah. But if you come, probably it might make a difference. You just come and accept your responsibility and do what you have to do because they get the chance already and they blow it. Now is the time for you to come and make things better. Don't go and tell them it's them. No. Them no hypocrite. They're doing things in big. When they want to cuss you, they're cussing you. When they want to do what they want to do, they're doing it for everybody to see. It's weed. What if you know the among that thing that church people does? God, Lord Jesus. Let me just say that. Let's go. Come on. Let's go. So now, he says, remember from whence you have fallen. Repent and do the first work, the things that you used to do before. Or else I will quickly come to you and remove your candlestick out of this place. Listen to me. You think that is when Jesus comes? That's not when Jesus comes. There are some candlestick that pelt far in the bush. There are some candlestick that going all over the place just so. He said, I'm going to remove you. I'm going to pelt you far. And you see some pelting taking place. You don't understand. It's God that removing. Because they do not love. Because we, you know why God takes the anointing away and takes us away and brings us to that kind of shame? is because we don't love him. We don't love him. We end up blaming people. Sleeping people blame people. Yeah. They say, why didn't you wake me up? Why didn't you call me? You cracker, you're sleeping. Some people, when they're sleeping, they just fight. The most dangerous person. You know, you have some people like kicking you up on your foot. When they're sleeping, they're fighting here, they just can't wake. So some people are sleeping so you could tell them anything. But watch, leave my life sleep here. Yeah? Because he just wake up fighting. That's what it takes for some people. And I'm just giving you the analogies. Listen, he said, I will come quickly. And I'm going to throw you as far as the east is from the west. And I'm telling you, don't make excuse for us. When you see what is happening to us, it's because something happened before. And God said, I had enough. He said, I will come. And I'm going to discard you. And there are a lot of us who have already been discarded. Woo-hoo. Discarded, but going through the motion. Okay. He said, you don't love me again. And that's the reason why. Not what you do. Oh, you see all them things you're doing there? You're just doing it because you're under pressure. You are just going on. Are you going on emotion? You're going mechanically. Listen. This day that we are living in, this day, this 2022, or the era that we are living in, is an era of broken promises, broken relationships. People don't care about others. They're just so selfish. People going down the aisle with you, and they know they ain't ready yet. And they're standing up and tell the preacher, I will, I do. And they know they don't, and they will never. Never keep their promise to love, to obey, to submit, to nothing. Just looking for trouble. Listen, you ever seen a day of more divorce? Some people that are staying together still. It's shame that keep them in. You don't have to say amen, sister. Well, your husband dead already, so don't stay. It's shame not keeping us. Broken promises, they're not real. He said there shall be truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good. They don't like good people. Traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasure more than lovers of God. You know what? If I had come and watered down the gospel of Jesus Christ, a lot of people would have loved me. I bet you. But I can't backslide in front of this congregation. Me? If I backslide for a minute, you know. Don't watch me so you know. If I backslide for a minute, you're going to know because I stopped preaching the way that I used to preach. You're going to feel it. You're going to know. Lord. But some preachers, they're living eternally wrong in front of their congregation and the congregation still love them. I can't practice that. I can't practice that here. I probably could go and start a new church and start lying to them, but I can't lie to this church and the bunch of people. I'm stuck. Listen, he says, and like in the days of Noah. so shall it be. He said they shall be eating and drinking and giving in marriage and just having a good time. And not only that, asleep in church. Listen. Asleep in church blames. God was so good to Adam and gave him such a dude. When push comes to shove, he started to blame God. He said, God, is the woman you give me? Is the woman? And that is the Adam thing in us. We like to blame. And I tell you what, blame in church is a sleep in church. A sleep in church is a blame in church. Blame, blame, blame. Oh, God. But you see, I know a sleeping church and I know a sleeping person. They don't have no reason to do what they do. No reason to behave the way that they're behaving. Absolutely none. And if you have a reason, come to the person. The Bible says one on one. No. They're sleeping so much, they don't want to do that. And they can't confront you. What stupid. You don't find something wrong? Well, you don't. Well, I have for 48 years, so I'm in church for 48 years, and I've been overseer for 35 years, and I have dealt with all levels of people, all kinds. So, some of us blame that we don't have enough. The master gave talents, 5, 2, and 3. 5, 2, and 1. Is that the writing? The fellow that get one, he said, the reason why I can't function, I ain't get enough. So that is why I bury the thing. All kind of stupid reason, you know? Use what you got. You want what somebody else have. Use what you got, baby. Use what you got. God's going to give you more. And furthermore, Jesus gave a parable of a sleeping church. He said, he gave a parable, he said that there was this king who made a marriage as a feast for his son and asked all the people, important people, to come to that marriage. Man, the first one say, he say, I married a wife. Whoa. And I can't make it. The next one say he bought a yoke of oxen. He can't make it. Next one say he bought lands. He can't make it. Let me tell you something. A sleeping church always can't do it because. Watch what's going on there now. I bet you we're going to have carnival just now. And the stadium going to be full. But the church going to be empty. Boy, I tell you, church people, hypocrite, because it's not COVID that make us not come to church. It's not COVID. Boy, it's not COVID at all. Them people going about their business just the same. It's only church that empty now. Since we start getting degree, and we having big transport and big house and that is what caused the problem. Yes. Because Adam says the woman. Yes. The job you gave me. Yes. And those children. Because, let me tell you something. I was in prayer meeting because sometimes God has given me a thought. You know, and I was be teaching in prayer meeting and so on. So I say, I was challenging them that are going to come because that's what's going on inside of me. And I'm going to preach a sermon. I'm going to title this. Dear God, don't answer my prayer. Please, God, don't answer my prayer. Because when you answer my prayer for money, and I get it, I don't want you. And when I get a nice wife, I don't want you. And when I'm healthy, I don't want you. And when you do all those nice things for me, I don't want you. So please, God, don't answer my prayer. And I say I'm going to preach that. But I changed my mind. But I want to tell you personally, tell God to take back some of those things that he gave you. Amen. You better do or else you're going to go to hell. Trust me. Yeah, I remember What? We live in total poverty. Yes. And we were on fire for God. Amen. We live when gun flying left, right, and center. We didn't even care to die. We live when we had no transport. Yes. Walking from here to Tongue and back for Bible school. Yes. And from here to Granby and back, rain. Yes. The road became river at times. When we looked for the shoes in our feet, they were gone. We had to walk on our own, crawl on our hands to cross bridges and to cross dangerous places because we couldn't see how we were going. And in those days, we were farming the land, going to Bible school and doing everything. And in those days, we had nothing. But now we... Lord have mercy. So give me a little advice here now. You think I should preach it? Yeah. Boy, God cannot trust me. He says, if riches come, do not set your heart on it. If your Cadillac come, don't worry about that. You're going to live in a community as Butch Groove and don't give somebody a drive? You got to be kidding. Don't come here. You don't belong to this church. You can't do that. You're sitting on the branch and cut it. Butch Groove people understand. Asking for a ride and asking a Christian for a ride. So you don't see we're doing better when we don't have nothing? We sleep in. We come into church. Nicole and them come into this church here from 2 days and 3 days old. 2 days we out on the evangelistic field all over the place we're preaching. Babies. When Celia have them churning she belly. I remember Ramsey Hill. You know Ramsey Hill? So she can't go up Ramsey Hill. She belly too big. So are they behind? Come on, God. Come on. But we go into church. Yeah. People have 2 and 3 cars in the yard and they end. You're going to tell me, Toto, we ain't sleeping? Yeah, we're probably dead, so that's something wrong. Either we dead or we sleeping. Yeah. Or we don't love God. Yeah. Something wrong. Yeah. Something. Church, I am here to... I mean, you find me strange. And I will always be the strangest preacher ever. But I will always say what God wants me to say. This is the time to awake out of sleep. This is the time to get up and do what God has called you to do. Get up. Oh my God, have mercy. This is the hour. And this is the day. Hallelujah. I'm going to cut this thing short. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm going to cut this thing short. He says, listen. He says, number one, remember from whence you have fallen. Remember what you used to be. Remember the presence of God and the fire of God in your life. He says, secondly, repent. Yes. Turn around. Change things around. Because he's not going to accept us. He's not going to accept us like that. Oh, no, baby. No. He said, no. He said, listen, I'm being merciful. I'm giving you a chance, and I'm giving you right here now, I'm giving you the formula. He says, remember, one. Number two, repent. And number three, start doing what you used to do. Forgive people of their trash. Not with that. Forgive them. Leave them alone. God have mercy. God won't forgive you if you don't forgive them. I mean, I know you think forgiveness is hugging and kissing. You don't even have to do that. No. If you don't have a relationship with somebody, you cannot have a relationship with somebody that have not repented. God is going to do you the same thing. What do you say? Forgive them. If they're hungry, feed them. If they're thirsty, give them drink. Say hi to them as much as possible. Amen. But once they hinder in you, something, every time you see them, you're getting angry. Something wrong with you. You're sleeping. Trust me. Let that person go. Oh God, let them go. Let them go. So I'm saying this morning to you, my dear, do not sleep as others. It's not a good thing to have a spiritual sleep. Israel slept. You see the consequence? I mean, oh my God. Woo. And the list goes on. We could preach and preach and preach and preach and preach about it. But this is the time to awake. Come on, be real. Recommit yourself to God. Be friends with God again. You know what is love? Anybody here know what is love? I don't mean talk love, you know. I mean do love. Love that you feel from inside. You don't want to be alone. You want to share. You want to talk. You want to give. You want to everything. These are the signs of it. You're warm. You love that person. Oh, God. That's how God wants it. And he ain't going to settle for nothing else. He said you could do what you want, but if you don't love me, I will know. Stand with me, please. He said, if you don't love me, I will know. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. God is giving us a chance this morning to get this thing right. Is there anybody here? You want to give your life to Jesus? You want to recommit your life to Jesus? You want to start loving Jesus for real? You want to let go of all of those distractions? Whatever is keeping you from being a... Whatever it is. We're going to pray this morning. I want to pray with you. And if you know anybody who's going through that, who is going through that situation, it's time to start praying for them because they're going to be dead. Trust me. It's more destruction is going to come upon the land. Hallelujah. Come on, let's get it going.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He is worthy of it all.
Is there anybody? I'm going to be praying with you right now.
You're worthy of it all.
Anybody who wants to stand proxy for somebody?
From
bring somebody's soul to God. Walk to the altar with somebody's soul. Make a declaration to God that you're holding up that person
to God.
Make up your mind you're not going through the motions anymore.
You're worthy.
This is church. This is church. Church is real.
You're worthy of it all.
Hallelujah.
For from you are all things.
Let us pray.
And to you are all things.
God is here.
You deserve the glory.
Oh God, I don't want to ask you what you're praying for. This is a symbol that you're surrendering to God. You're not going to know mechanical. Or if you know anybody who's doing it, pray for them. Come a little closer. Because it's not going to work.
Your throne. And all the elders
Almighty God
cast their crowns before
this altar this morning is yours.
Of God,
and we come to you asking for pardon.
You're worthy of it all.
Lord, we have come short.
You are worthy.
Lord, we made errors. We've been pretensive. We asked for mercy.
From you are all
we ask for your grace this morning.
And to you are all things.
Oh God.
You
oh God,
glory.
In the name of Jesus, touch this man. Put your hands on
You're
him.
Worthy of it all.
Lord, deposit your presence in him. And give him
You're
the fire of God.
Of it all.
So that he will always be awake. Lord, make him whole.
Fall from
me. Give him a miracle just like you did for me.
And to you are all things,
my brother.
You deserve the glory.
Right. God, touch my brother. I pray, God, that you go to cleanse him.
That's what this
take the ashes
altar
away
is for.
And let the fire of God flame in his life again.
You don't have
Lord, in
to
Jesus'
carry.
Name, touch his brother.
Your burden anymore.
In the name,
there's a light in the darkness.
God Almighty,
there's a love that's true.
Touch this man.
Jesus
God, have
is
mercy.
Waiting. He
Was
is waiting
of God?
There for you.
Come
quickly now, before
Lord,
they close the door. That's
God,
what this altar is for.
Touch this child. Lord, I release the fire
That's
of God.
That's what this altar is for.
Fire of God, Lord. That will bring her back to the altar.
You don't have to
Jesus.
Carry those burdens anymore.
Oh, God. Kenna, he's going to
There's a light in the darkness.
That's what
There's a love that's true.
I'm wondering all about you.
Jesus is waiting. He is waiting there for you. Come quickly now before they close the door.
In the name of Jesus.
That's what this altar is for. The service
in her life.
Is nearing
oh God,
the end.
Forgive her. God, make her whole.
And the choir is singing.
Let your will be done.
Just as I am. And now
oh
as the old song is played.
Oh my God. Touch this little woman, please.
People at the altar.
I release the fire of God.
And kneeling down to pray.
Lord, break every
Some are finding
break every chain.
Forgiveness
Lord,
for the sins.
Your altar and strengthen
Some home. Are fighting battles. They are struggling to win.
God.
The time has come to give them
In
to
the, name
the
of
Lord.
Jesus, I touch this little woman. I pray.
That's what this altar is for.
And set her free, God. And rekindle the fire of God in her life.
That's what
Lord,
this altar is for.
In Jesus' name. Thank you, God. Set her free.
You don't have
Hallelujah.
To carry
Hallelujah.
Those burdens anymore.
Give
There's
the
a light in
Jesus.
The darkness. There's a love that's true. Jesus is waiting. He is waiting there for you. Come quickly now. Before they close the door. That's what this altar is for.
In Jesus.
That's what this altar is for.
Touch these children.
You don't have to carry those burdens anymore.
As they recommend
them, there's a light in the darkness.
Let the fire
There's a love that's true. Jesus is waiting.
Awake,
he is
Lord,
waiting
God.
There
the
for you.
Let
Come quickly
God.
Now.
Bless them.
Before
give them
they
grace
close
to stand
the door.
Lord, give this girl grace to grow. The devil doesn't
That's what you know that. You know that. Is for. You can give your burdens to the Lord.
In Jesus' name.
That's what this altar is
for. God Almighty. In the name of Jesus, I release the power of God upon you.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
I pray that the love for God is going to be rekindled by the fire of God.
Jesus,
it's going to take full control.
I prevail.
Fire.
Let
the fire burn.
Sickness.
Get it up. In Jesus' name.
By God. The blood.
Touch this woman. Break every
Jesus.
Mental. Break every chain. Set her free.
I prevail. Over sickness.
That you will lift up
the blood of Jesus.
God, give her grace. I pray that you're going to touch these children.
Prevail.
God, and seal them.
Over
don't let them go.
Sickness.
Keep them close to you. Please, Lord. And God.
By
in the name of
the
Jesus.
Blood
the Son of God.
So I prevail
to use you for His glory.
I prevail.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
I prevail.
Hallelujah.
I prevail.
Hallelujah. God bless you, Jada. God bless you.
I prevail.
God bless you, my
dear. I prevail.
Jada, just flow with God.
And I prevail.
Don't do it for people to
I
see.
Prevail.
God, let the fire
Lord,
of God fall on these girls here, please. In the name
I prevail.
In
I prevail.
God, break every fetter. Break every chain.
I prevail.
Give them freedom and liberty. In
Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
You might be wondering, that's what God says, how are you going to do it? He said, I called Abraham. He didn't know where he was going. He didn't know what he was going to do. All he did was to walk with me. And I took him there. Woo! And you heard me saying this morning, I don't know how I got here. I don't know how I made 48 years. It was because I decided I'm going to walk with God. And through hills and valleys and fire and ups and downs and all persecution and all pain and unspeakable words, God took me here. And I tell you this morning, if you're going to drop it and walk with God, God will take you there. I bet you. Oliver, walk with God. Yes. God's going to help you because you're wondering how you make it. You're wondering how you reach where you reach it. You should have dead and gone already. God Almighty, touch Oliver, please. Mend his broken heart, his brokenness. Lord, you know what is best for him. Sometimes we ask you for stuff and it ain't good for us. And we don't even know the consequence of it. Lord, you take control
Never
of Oliver.
Up.
And as Oliver walks with you,
Jesus,
just let your will be done in his life, God.
His
make him over. Break him. Lord, I know that you are the he's just the clay. And sometimes we go through broken things. But he's going to put you back Oliver, trust him. Lord,
never give
your
up.
Presence I release in Oliver.
Jesus,
Lord, give him joy again and
coming.
Peace again and the power of God again. Jesus, mighty name.
Never give up.
Whoa. He says, walk with me.
Keep
I will take you there. Trust me. In the name of Jesus, Lord, touch this woman. And please,
there
let the fire of God fall upon her,
God,
to propel her, to motivate
when
her,
I feel
and God, to cleanse
so
her. God, in Jesus' name, take this woman, please.
And feel that all hope is gone. But there is one who can Let me just address something here this morning. I feel so heavy for the young people. I look at you and you just look so lost. You came here, but I know for a fact that most of you are going back home and live the very, very same life. I've spoken over and over. God wants your heart and he wants it wholeheartedly. I know you all. And I've spoken, we come Friday after Friday, but what have you done with the advice and the time we spend here every Friday night? Youth, I am burdened for you. Jada, Jadon, Akim, you all know I've spoken over and over. God is coming. You all are young. Use the time that you have wisely for God. These are the things that will last. I feel your pain. I feel your heaviness. You come, but you go back. You don't change. You don't change. God is going to hold you all accountable. When he comes, you all are going to be sorry if you all are left here, because I speak over and over to you all. I have spoken, and God is speaking to you all. You all know what you are supposed to do. Do it. He's going to hold you accountable. I've done my part. I try. Give God your all.
There's somebody this morning, you're struggling and you're wondering, how am I going to get there? How am I going to do this? This is not your problem. That's not your problem. What you have to do is to surrender to him, and he will take you there. Now listen to me. Don't run away from your troubles. Don't run away from your problems. If you run away from your problems, you fail to allow God to break you. Let God break you. If it is somebody in your life that is doing that, let them do it. Let them do it. Let them do it. Go through. Just listen. Make up. This is what God is saying. Go through. Let your troubles break you. You're going to feel some pain. You will. I'm telling you, you will. God didn't promise to take you there just on a bed of roses. It's persecution and trials and
You had to be broken and beaten and all. Listen, that's how he got the best out of Paul. Let your circumstances deal with you, and you're going to see the anointing of God coming out of your life. I'm promising you that. I'm telling you of so many years of troubles in my life. That's what brought me where I am today. You didn't come here on a bed of roses. Come here with bitter tears, crying alone, things that I could tell no one. Nobody. And I feel my pain. It's me and me alone and God. But I decided I ain't going back. I ain't going back. I'm not going to do stupidness for a bunch of people to see and for nobody to see. That's what I made up my mind to do. And my troubles molded me and kept me. I'm telling you, let it happen. Sacrifice yourself to God. I'm not telling you that he's going to repay you here, because I'm still asking him for a few things. You may never get it here. But I know you'll get it over yonder. As I was telling you this morning, I believe the gospel. Jesus died for me. God died for me. He made himself a man for me. And that story is true. Come on this morning, believe this, to give yourself to him. He's our redeemer. He's everything. And he will take you there. God help you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So I'm done. The announcements, please. You may have a seat.
A pleasant good afternoon to everyone. The announcement for the week. On Monday, the ladies' ministry meet at 6:30. On Tuesday, pastoral counseling by appointment. Wednesday, prayer meeting and Bible study at 7. Thursday, prayer and fast at 10 a.m. Friday, youth meeting at 6:30. And kids club on Saturday at 3 p.m. The church will be hosting a fun day on August 8th. That's Carnival Monday at Mellow. So the Palms, the venue is not yet finalized. And it starts at 10 a.m. with a brunch. And then for lunch, we'll be having an hour-long competition, the men versus the women, Manish Waters, barbecue, pilau, and fruit juices. And we'll be also having some traditional games. And your donations are needed, fruits, vegetables, seasoning, coconut, etc. And you can give it to any member of the events planning committee. Are you interested in learning how to play an instrument, either the guitar or the bass or a keyboard? Free classes are available for all ages, and you can contact Brother Jason as soon as possible, Jason Newton, if you are interested. Okay? The couples ministry, you are reminded of your monthly contribution of $20 to be paid to any member of the couples ministry. Executive member, of the couples ministry. And the church will be hosting some upcoming events on October the 30th, Saturday, October 30th. We'll be having a barbecue luncheon and a concert on December the 2nd, 2022. Remember to pray for and visit the sick in our congregation and community, and also remember those who are hospitalized. Baby's dedication is the first Sunday of every month, and parents must attend a counseling session before the dedication. That's all the announcement I have. We also have Sister Doreen has wedding anniversaries.
Pleasant good afternoon, everyone. For wedding anniversary today, 24th of July, we have Brother and Sister Newton. They are celebrating 18 years today. And on Friday, 29th of July, we have Mr. and Mrs. Desmond Joseph celebrating 5 years. Come forward, please.